Hello, and welcome to Funnel's YouTube channel, where we talk all things digital marketing, data visualization, and analytics. All the great content that you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer. In the following couple of minutes, we're going to uncover the data mesh basics. What is this concept? How does data mesh affect marketing? And what's the true business value behind it? To keep it simple, data mesh is a new approach or strategy to data management. It focuses on the decentralization of data and encourages you to view and use it as a strategic asset rather than a byproduct of your actions. In doing so, you shorten the path between data and business value. Let me explain in more detail. The evolution of data analytics. All right, so before jumping into the underlying principles of data mesh, let's go through a 1-minute crash course of the evolution of data analytics. It's no news that we live in a fast-paced, technologically driven world. And with our focus on being more data-driven, we have gradually seen the cost for data storage decrease. And thanks to the rise of artificial intelligence and machine learning, computing powers have exponentially advanced. These trends all encouraged a centralized approach to data management. But what does that really mean in practice? A centralized data architecture typically means having lots of data come from all parts of the business, storing it in a single repository, and having different consumers of this data, like finance or marketing, make requests for reports and insights. In short, this approach means that, for example, the business intelligence team owns the entire process of collecting, mapping, maintaining, and sharing data so that it's ready to be used for insights in the respective departments. So, what's the challenge? Firstly, the ever-growing complexity that comes with higher data volume. Now, you might be wondering, where does this higher data volume actually come from? Well, in 2022, there were roughly 5 billion active internet users worldwide, which is 62% of the total population. Now, picture all of these people using their mobile phones, social media, platforms, and other technologies that are constantly producing, collecting, and storing data. If we look at the marketing landscape alone, we're already talking over 10,000 tools. So, when we zoom out and we look at the entire scope of technologies producing data, it's no surprise to know that the data volume continues to double every 3 years. Secondly, we're also living in an age of advanced data modeling through the rise of machine learning and artificial intelligence, which allows you to find patterns and make predictions on your data so that you can make adjustments for better performance. For example, you could be using machine learning to create more detailed buyer personas. This would give you more insights on your customers' preferences and thereby help you make the necessary product changes. And finally, underpinning all of this is the fact that more teams across the organization are becoming increasingly data-driven to prove their impact on the bottom line. While some organizations have taken a centralized approach to those challenges, limiting the amount of people who can actually access and use it presents 3 key challenges. But before I jump in, let me give you a quick analogy. Let's imagine a restaurant. In that restaurant, you have a head chef and a bunch of other sous chefs preparing dinner for the evening. Now, let's say that this head chef refused to share the recipes on the menu with the rest of his and her team and needed to approve every dish before it went out. It would soon become impossible for the kitchen staff to cook enough meals to serve the guests. Each part of the kitchen team will be held up by the chef, making the chef the bottleneck. And I imagine we're all familiar with bottlenecks. So, what would that cause? Well, number one, the rest of the staff wouldn't feel responsible for any meal produced because they don't have any ownership. Number two, the quality of the dishes would be compromised because the staff can't really efficiently create each dish without the chef's input, so things go cold or aren't ready at the same time. And lastly, the number of dinner guests catered to is a fraction of what it could be due to the lack of scalability and having the chef shadowing and approving every meal. You see where I'm going here? The same goes for teams who don't work with data effectively. Solution: along came data mesh. Though it may not be surprising to hear that 75% of IT and business leaders recognize the importance of data as a key driver of innovation, 57% also admit that the volume of data is growing faster than the organization's ability to keep up with it. Why? Well, if your organization's data management approach resembles anything of the do-it-all master chef in the kitchen, you're not exactly set up for success. This is where Data Mesh comes into play. Let's dive into what it actually is and why it benefits you and the entire organization. To keep it simple, Data Mesh is a new approach or strategy to data management. It focuses on the decentralization of data and encourages you to view and use it as a strategic asset rather than a byproduct of your actions. In doing so, you shorten the path between data and business value. Let me explain in more detail. There are four key pillars that the paradigm shift of Data Mesh rests on. So let's break them down into smaller, bite-sized chunks. Domain-driven ownership. The idea behind this is to have teams with domain knowledge. This could be departments such as marketing or finance, actually owning the data that they turn into insights and actions, because they have the context that makes that data meaningful. Data as a product. With this, the days of reducing your data to being a report on last week's numbers kind of tool are over. Instead, we welcome an era of proactively using your insights to experiment more frequently and help develop a competitive advantage. Self-serve functionality. Different domains in a company, whether it's marketing, operations, or IT, should have access to the data that they need for them to make their respective analysis and reporting. Federated governance. While there may be overarching guidelines of how to work with that data in your organization, individual teams should be empowered to make independent decisions with the data that's actually affecting their particular domain and ensure their own data quality. Just to clarify, drawing the line between self-serve functionality and federated governance isn't that easy. But ultimately, you need to have teams that are responsible for ensuring data quality and accuracy. However, they also need to find ways to do that while enabling other teams to be autonomous to avoid becoming a bottleneck. Depending on your organization and the complexity of your data and tech stack, this could look different, so it's impossible for me to tell you exactly where that line is. What's important for you is to question if you're getting the right balance and empowering other teams for the benefit of your organization. Okay, so you might think to yourself, so what? And it's a fair question. What are the actual benefits of Data Mesh for you? To answer that question, let me first give you a real-life scenario to highlight the difference between a centralized versus decentralized data management approach. Say I'm a performance marketing manager at a global e-commerce company. My role comes with the responsibility of being able to answer some burning questions, like how much we've spent on marketing, what our return on investment is, and why our performance has gone up or down this month. How do I get answers to my questions? Well, in a setup where there's little autonomy and scalability, I'd reach out to our BI team and ask for a report covering the latest numbers, only to find out that there is a queued backlog of similar requests coming from sales, finance, product, you name it. Once I do get my report a couple days later, our CMO might ask to include a couple of other KPIs and change the way the data is visualized, which would have to wait another couple of days as I go back to our BI team and repeat the previous process. Really, it's no fun for anyone. In an organization that values a data mesh approach, this data would be accessible in different tools across various teams. I would easily be able to use the data independently to answer all my performance-related questions, as well as the BI team that needs it for broader business analytics. So, the key benefits of Data Mesh are greater independence and flexibility. For you, this means quicker access to critical data that's relevant for your decision-making. For the business, this means overall more efficiency and greater scalability across teams. Secondly, it encourages transparency of data across the whole organization. This means that teams can increase their data literacy because they are now in charge of their own data domains, which will help foster a data-driven culture across the board. For these benefits to really come to life, it's worth mentioning that with more ownership comes greater responsibility, which means it requires each team to be a good steward of that data to ensure that it remains accurate, clean, and available for the rest of the organization. Ultimately, this is relevant for the entire organization. If you can shift the entire company's mindset towards this way of working, you will increase the efficiency and output of each team, whilst maintaining data accuracy and integrity. One of the key impacts of decentralizing your data management is that it allows teams to actually tie their data directly to business outcomes, rather than raw data. This is because the ownership now lies within the business domains, which means that instead of processing all available data, each team has context that allows them to carefully select which data needs to be processed and analyzed. What does that mean for you? Well, one thing's for sure, a decentralized approach to data management is coming our way, and the businesses that really prepare and organize themselves most effectively will reap the most rewards. In practice, this will look vastly different across each business, depending on your current tech stack, size, and way of working. So, in the end, there really is no one-size-fits-all solution to your data management needs. Instead, this philosophy may help us navigate through the proliferation of data around us and give us a new perspective on how to make sense of it. If you found this video useful, subscribe, where you'll get more videos about digital marketing best practices, marketing data and analytics, and data visualization tips and tricks. All the great content you need to shortcut your way to being a better marketer.